Om Namah Shiva students, in my last video I have shown some reactions of amide and aromatic amines like electrophilic substitution reaction, nitration. So today we will start from sulfonation reaction. On sulfonation, aniline gives sulfanilic acid. Sulfanilic acid is C6H5NH2SO3H. This is aniline on reaction with H2SO4. It goes to NH3+H SO4-. And at 453 to 473 Kelvin, it gives sulfanilic acid, and it is the Zwitter ion in NH3+SO3-. Aniline does not undergo Friedel-Crafts reaction due to salt formation with aluminium chloride. The Lewis acid, which is used as a catalyst. Due to this, nitrogen of aniline requires positive charge and hence behave like a strong deactivating group for further chemical reaction. Oxidation. Use of different oxidizing agents gives different products. In presence of acidified KMnO4 or Na2Cr27 plus CuSO4 plus dilute acid, it gives aniline black, a dye. In presence of chromic acid, it gives parabenzoquinone. In presence of carose acid is H2SO5, it gives nitrobenzene and nitrosobenzene. Concentrated nitric acid decomposes aniline. So separation of mixtures of amines 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree. There are three methods. First method, fractional distillation. This method is based on the boiling points of amines and is used satisfactorily in industry. Second method, Hoffman's method. The diethyl oxalate is called Hoffman's reagent with which mixture of amines is treated. And 1 degree amine forms solid dialkyl oxamide. 2 degree amine forms liquid dialkyl oxamide, oxamic ester. And 3 degree amines do not react. And third method, Hinzberg test. We have already done Hinzberg. This is Hinzberg test. Aryl sulfonyl chloride reaction with aryl sulfonyl chloride. So 1 degree amine gives soluble N ethyl benzyl sulfonyl amide. 2 degree gives insoluble NN diethyl benzene sulfonamide, but 3 degree does not react. Basic nature of amines. This is very important topic. Now, aliphatic bases. as increasing strength in nitrogenous bases is related to the readiness with which they are prepared to take up protons, and therefore to the availability of the unshared electron pair on nitrogen. We might expect to see an increase in basic strength going from ammonia to 1 degree to 2 degree to 3 degree amines due to the increasing inductive effect of successive alkyl groups making the nitrogen's atom more negative. An actual series of amines was found to have related pKa values as follows. So due to the presence of 1 alkyl group in 1 degree amine, the bonded electrons are pushed towards nitrogen, and in 2 degree amines, 2 alkyl group push the bonded electrons towards nitrogen, and in 3 degree amine, 3 alkyl group push the electrons to nitrogen. So nitrogen is more negative in 3 degree amine and ready to accept proton. So 3 degree amine is more basic than 2 degree, than 1 degree, than ammonia. But actual series of amines was found to have related pKa values . If we look into the values of basic strength for primary amine, it is 10.64, for secondary 10.77, tertiary 9.80, and for ammonia it is 9.25. And if ethyl group is introduced, the value is 10.67 for primary, 10.93 for secondary, 10.88 for tertiary, and 9.25 for ammonia. So here the highest value is for when two ethyl groups are introduced, and a little difference is noticed when three ethyl group is introduced. So it will be seen that the introduction of an alkyl group into ammonia increases the basic strength markedly as expected. The introduction of a second alkyl group further increases the basic strength. But the net effect of introducing the second alkyl group is very much less marked than the first. The introduction of a third alkyl group to yield a tertiary amine, however, actually decreases the basic strength in both the series quoted. This is due to the fact that the basic strength of an amine in water is determined not only by electron availability on the nitrogen atom, but also by the extent to which the cation formed by uptake of a proton can undergo solvation and so become stabilized. The more hydrogen atoms attached to nitrogen in the cation, the greater the possibilities of powerful solvation via hydrogen bonding between these and water. The greater the possibilities of powerful solvation via hydrogen bonding between these and water. So this is the hydrogen bonding for primary amines, secondary amines, and tertiary amines. So hydrogen bonding is more in primary amine than secondary and then tertiary, because the non-availability of hydrogen in the amine. Thus, on going along the series NH3, RNH2, R2NH, R3N, the inductive effect will tend to increase the basicity, but progressively less stabilization of the cation by hydration will occur, which will tend to decrease the basicity. The net replacing effect of introducing successive alkyl groups thus becomes progressively smaller, and an actual changeover takes place on going from a secondary to a tertiary amine. If this is the real explanation, not such changeover should be observed if measurements of basicity are made in a solvent in which hydrogen bonding cannot take place. It has indeed been found that in chlorobenzene or in gas phase, the order of basicity of butyl amine is 3 degree then 2 degree then 1 degree. In my next video, I will discuss the basicity of aromatic amines. So, till then, Om Namah Shivaya.